Hello, everybody. Welcome to this episode of our podcast. Today, we have Rachit Raj with us. He's currently working as a game developer at Stealth Mode Startup in Bangalore. And he graduated from IIT Roorkee in 2019 with a degree in chemical engineering. Hey, Rachit, welcome to the podcast. How are you?
Hey, Kildea. I'm good. Thank you. How are you?
I'm doing good. How has the pandemic been for you?
Not much effect to my personal life, honestly. It hasn't changed that much. Just going to office part has moved to working from home. Nothing much difference.
Yeah, for us. For us, first year online, new experience. Nobody else is going to have that experience. Yeah, we're just adjusting and being optimistic that everything would come under control eventually. So, yes. All right, then let's get started. A lot of people are into gaming and then they get curious about how that game was developed, right? So what are the skill sets that a game developer requires to develop?
So basically game development is not a one-man job, actually. It requires a team with different skill sets. So some involve like programming to the lowest level, some involve creating art, creating the visuals and terrains that it comes under 3D and like game art, that is the job of a game artist. Okay, then like if you ignore the multiplayer games, so every game has a story or something to basically keep a hook on. So that is the job of a game designer. And like there are sound artists as well, and in the end, like game developers, like game engineers are generally called game developers in India at least. So they are the ones who are writing code. Even game developers are divided into multiple categories. Like someone is specialized in writing code for say the graphics part, someone is for the audio part, and someone for like as small as or as big as a gameplay or as small as a moving mechanism. Everyone is specialized in a different field.
All right, so game development is a whole team thing, right? The different verticals and different jobs that people eventually do to build the game that we get to play.
Yeah.
So what are the opportunities both in India and outside? Like once somebody develops those skill sets, what shall they look towards?
Honestly, like this is one of the best time to get into game development because like if you'll Google it, actually gaming industry is currently bigger than every other media source.
Okay, great.
You have a like greater than your movies, greater than your TV series, Netflix, everything. And the tournaments are being organized, which are bigger than say your French Open. The prize pool's bigger than French Open. So this is one of the best time to get into game development. And in India as well, the startups, there are a lot of startups that are emerging currently. There are not many AAA studios, to be honest. Like a few you can name, but nothing more than that. And even for the studios from outside that have offices in India, they mostly, like from my experience with the people that I've talked to, they mostly give you like some bug testing, some like not exactly in the development part, but in the support part.
All right. Otherwise, the industry is great and booming. So lots of opportunities to open.
Like outside, you'll get a lot of opportunities. In India, I think currently startups are the best way to go.
Okay, fair enough. Nice. So you've been the lead programmer and developer at Design Studio, and then you've done internships as a game developer in Livelight, right? So how was your experience? How did it help you to, you know, develop the skill sets or put those skill sets into use in real projects?
So actually, like, I think my first exposure to actual game development was at Design Studio only. So before that, I mostly used to make mechanics and all. At Design Studio, we made an AR game. A treasure, and basically where you go in the campus and scan billboards and all, and you'll find a treasure. So we launched it in Cognizant and Sushti. So that was basically my first exposure. And with that, I learned Unity and all. So Unity, 3D development, these fields I tried for that particular project. And using that project as a base, I actually applied for internships using Angel and LinkedIn. and I got into Livelike. Livelike was actually very fun. It spoiled me, to be honest. So just like imagine for a second. So Livelike was my internship in second year. Imagine a second year, right? Landing into an office where like you can play games for the entire day. Like they had PlayStations, they had VR games there. And so I was spoiled in a way, like I'd go early, I'll play some games, I'll finish my task early and then again start playing games.
Yeah, look, a lot addictive, you can say. Ki kaam karne ja rahe hain, but it's enjoyable and addictive.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so eventually all of this helped you to choose game development, right? So did you always want to pursue game development or was it through these experiences? Like, how did you finally decide?
Okay, so I'll actually start with a story with I have only told to 1% Ella. He was my mentor in college. Okay, so basically what started, it was in fourth standard. I was in the bus, okay? And some seniors, I think 11th or 12th class, they used, we were taking computer classes and they were talking about game development. That was the first time I actually heard about game development. Honestly, like many people, even when I was passing out, many people didn't know that someone makes games. But I was lucky enough that I got to hear that someone does it and it is actually said to be very difficult. So yeah, kabhi to try karna hai, like difficult is to try to karna hai. So that was the first. Then college mein, like, okay, so I came to college with a plan. My plan was, first year main kuch nahi kar raha. I literally, like, even my roommate used to shout at me, bhai thoda padh le. Because I used to play games entire time. And in 2-1 actually, in my third semester. So, yaar, matlab, first year's habit, it was not dropping off, so I actually met a senior, so I was introduced to a senior by a close friend in second semester. And he asked just me, bhai, kya kar raha hai? Like, so basically all my friends are designers, okay? And they tried to teach me designing multiple times, but they failed. Because, like, yaar, sab cheez sab pe click nahi karta.
Fine.
So, uske baad, bhai, like, the senior asked me and बस गेम खेल रहा था मैं एंड आई लाइक प्रोग्रामिंग एंड ऑल जस्ट आउट ऑफ द ब्लू इट केम फ्रॉम माय माइंड आई विल ट्राई गेम डेवलपमेंट कोई रिसर्च नहीं कुछ भी नहीं
जस्ट इट वाज जस्ट अ थॉट दैट यू नो दैट रिमेंड विद यू सिंस
लास्ट नॉट इवन अ थॉट ऑनेस्टली आई हैवंट थॉट इट आई वाज थिंकिंग अबाउट एक्चुअली लाइक गोइंग टू प्ले गेम्स प्रोफेशनली दैट वाज द पॉइंट वेयर आई वाज थिंकिंग बट इट साउंड्स वेरी एब्सर्ड व्हेन यू से इट Like I tweaked it that I want to do game programming and just uske baad like so he actually told me that he knows a senior, he'll introduce me, he has worked a little on game development. So this senior was Sachin Nehru and he was gonna introducing me to Atul Nayyar. Okay, so Atul sir has worked on game development earlier. So ab yaar, Atul sir was senior, a lot senior than me, so ab I won't go without a preparation. तो उस वक्त मैंने actually थोड़े tutorials देखे, try किए, अच्छा लग गया. So that was actually how I exactly landed in game development. उसके बाद just I kept randomly exploring things inside game development as well. I learned 3D, I learned even I honestly I know Photoshop and Illustrator, but I cannot design. I can give you important feedbacks, but I cannot design. So all these skill sets actually I acquired after like deciding that this is a, so at this point it was defined that I am going in gaming industry. It is koi bhi position pe jao, worst case scenario I'll go as a tester, but I'll go in gaming industry.
All right, so that was a great experience, I must say, ki no realize ho gaya ki game development is what you need to do.
I was pretty lucky, honestly, ki second year mein I got to know ki kis field mein, because a lot of people get confused even after getting jobs, ki is this the right industry for them.
Yeah, right, correct. Even after getting jobs, they switch jobs and then it's kind of a struggle, which, you know, you don't really have to go through because you know what you are doing and that's what you want to do. So what were the difficulties? Like, I mean, was there any peer pressure or parental pressure? Because game development is not one of the most conventional jobs that people take, right?
Yes.
So how was the experience?
सो यार मतलब सी इन कॉलेज आई हैड एक्चुअली नो सीनियर अपार्ट फ्रॉम अतुल सर टू कॉन्टैक्ट अबाउट गेम डेवलपमेंट. सो आई हैड टू फाइंड सोर्सेज ऑन इंटरनेट एंड ऑल. सो आई यूज टू रीड ब्लॉग्स एक्सेट्रा. एंड एक्चुअली बाई द टाइम बाई आई थिंक थर्ड या सेकेंड सेमेस्टर आई वॉज एक्चुअली प्रिटी कॉन्फिडेंट इन माई स्किल्स दैट आई कैन गेट अ जॉब इजीली इन गेम डेवलपमेंट. आई न्यू गेटिंग इन द गेमिंग इंडस्ट्री इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट बट यार आई वॉज एक्चुअली बींग कॉन्फिडेंट एज वेल एज कॉकी एज वेल कि आई हैव द स्किल्स वाई वोंट समवन हायर मी. बट द थिंग इज दिस डजंट ट्रांसलेट टू एवरी वन. सो इवन एक्चुअली लाइक माई फादर वाज ट्राइंग कि यार गेट का एग्जाम दे दो और आई एक्चुअली डिडंट सेट इन प्लेसमेंट.
अरे
पापा बोलते थे कि प्लेसमेंट में बैठ जाओ जस्ट टेक अ जॉब एंड इफ यू डोंट वांट टू गो डोंट गो टू बट आई नो माय वे अराउंड आई गेट
एटलीस्ट
जॉब आई वुड
हाँ
अप्लाई. सो लाइक उसके बाद लाइक व्हेन द प्लेसमेंट वाज स्टार्ट हो गया एंड लाइक यू हैड नो वे आउट एंड आई टोल्ड कि मैं कुछ और कर ही नहीं रहा. आई एम नॉट गिविंग एनी एग्जाम्स. आई एम जस्ट गोइंग इन गेम डेवलपमेंट. आई एम नॉट इवन गोइंग फॉर मास्टर्स एनीवेयर. सो लाइक एक्चुअली पेरेंट्स ही यही करना यही करो अच्छे से करो.
So they've been very supportive in that sense.
हाँ हाँ सी द थिंग इज अंटिल दे नो एग्जैक्टली लाइक व्हाट यू आर डूइंग दे कैन नॉट सपोर्ट यू. तो अब मैंने क्या किया था कि आई यूज टू मेक स्मॉल प्रोटोटाइप्स ऑन अवर. ओके तो मैंने उनको उनके लाइक वीडियोस या उनके एक्चुअल एपीकेज मैंने भेज दिए कि ये ट्राई करो एक बार. लाइक मम्मी को अच्छा लगा. कोई कोई गेम मम्मी लाइक दो दो दिन कंटिन्यूअसली खेल रही है. तो दैट वाज लाइक अ ट्रिक फ्रॉम माय साइड कि हाउ डू आई कन्विंस कि दिस इज अ गुड थिंग.
Then they realize that yes, this is something good that you're doing, and you have those skills because they, of course, immersed into playing those games. So, yeah, that's been great for you too. So, you eventually talk to people, right? Talk to your senior that helped you a lot. So, that is what you would suggest other people do, right? Because everybody is confused. Mostly people are confused about what they want to do. So, talking to seniors and talking to people in that field is definitely one thing that one must do, right?
हाँ इट रियली हेल्प्स. इवन इफ लाइक यू डोंट नो अ फील्ड जस्ट पिक एनी वन. लाइक आई एम श्योर एनी वन वुड इन द कॉलेज वुड हेल्प यू. एनी सीनियर वुड हेल्प यू आउट टू फिगर आउट व्हाट ही इज वर्किंग ऑन. एंड एक्चुअली लाइक इट हेल्प्स इन एक्सप्लोरेशन एंड ऑल. एंड यू अनलेस यू हैव एक्सप्लोर्ड अ लॉट ऑफ फील्ड्स यू कैन नॉट से यार दिस इज द थिंग दैट आई विल डू आई विल बी एबल टू डू फॉर द एंटायर लाइफ.
Yeah, correct. And you already had the experience that designing is not something that you're interested in. So you got to know
हाँ
कि ठीक है, डिजाइनिंग नहीं करनी है.
डिजाइन. सो इट स्टार्टेड बाय वेब डिजाइनिंग इज नॉट फॉर मी. डिजाइनिंग इज नॉट फॉर मी. देन गेम आई यूज्ड टू लाइक 3D. आई यूज्ड टू लाइक एनिमेटिंग बट एज टाइम पास यार ये अच्छा तो लग रहा है बट आई कैन नॉट डू दिस फॉर माय एंटायर लाइफ.
All
सो
right. So you've been a gamer, right? As you told, even during your internship, you were hooked at playing games, and right now you are developing games. So it's been great for you. What do you think is the future of the gaming industry? I mean, in the sense, what type of games would people get to play? Mixed reality, virtual reality, all of this is all these technologies exist right now, and what more shall people look up to? Because I have a lot of friends who are into gaming, so they really enjoy developing a character in that world, and they get to learn. It's not just, something they do to pass their time. It's a hobby, a legit hobby that they pursue. So what's in the market for them?
Yeah, so currently actually I think market is a little bit biased towards mobile gaming in India. Little bit kya yaar, matlab, it's mostly biased towards mobile gaming in India
Yeah, because
because
mostly people would get the access to mobiles faster than the other PlayStations or devices.
exactly. Even like the systems required to play computer high-end computer games, most people do not have accessibility to that. So that's why mobile gaming is rising at a very alarming rate, honestly. And मतलब AR VR तो the games are developing, but it will take some time. Like I think 5 6 years at least to reach every person in India. उतना accessibility होने में तो time लगेगा. But yes, AR VR is basically the near future. I mean, if you can say near future of immersive user experience.
Nice, great. How was your college experience? The highlights, best moments that you'd like to share with us?
यार, so I joined as a chemical engineer. But from the first lecture, honestly, I knew ये तो नहीं कर सकता यार. So and first year, like I told, like I was just playing games first year. Luckily, I had like people around my room who used to play games as well. So we used to play 6-7 hours continuous of CS. And second year, actually, it took a toll for me because second year, say everyone starts to get serious. And I was not getting anyone to play with. So I started looking out options, blogs वगैरह पढ़ने लग गया. And like I told, second year के internship. So it spoiled me very badly. So my third year, actually, it was ruined, honestly. So, because I, यार मतलब game start कर दिए थे अच्छे खासे. And like, how do I say it? So basically, I was not attending any classes. I was not studying. I honestly passed because of my friends. Like every single exam, that starts at 9 a.m. in the morning. I'd go to their room at 7:30 after breakfast. भाई मेरे को बता दे पास होने के लिए क्या करना है. And they would literally like give me highlighted notes. Just read these and you'll get this much marks and you'll pass. So that's how I passed most of the subjects.
Kudos to your friends.
Honestly, yaar, matlab, you can't even thank enough. Like, kitna bhi try karta tha, mere se to nahi ho pata. So, bhai, uske baad, like, I honestly got into pretty bad gaming addiction in my fifth semester. So it ruined everything for me for some time. Like social life was zero, and I actually realized after 2 months, 2.5 months, when I and like yeah, sub zero, like I have to go to cold turkey on it. There is no other solution. I was showing withdrawal symptoms of gaming. People don't understand how critical a gaming addiction can be, but I've been there, and it's nothing to be joked around. And uske baad bhai, like, after that time, actually, I started getting serious. Chala ja, kuch to kar lete. And uske baad I started preparing again, like because my 3-1 got ruined. So in order to compensate, I had to do a lot of things in 4-1. So udhar kuch time gaya, but overall, like, yeah, it was hanging around with friends. Actually, even 4-1, 4-2 were very difficult times for me. That I got through only because of support of friends and parents.
All right. So that's been your college experience. And would you like to talk more about the whole gaming addiction thing? Like how badly it can affect somebody. And if somebody is into that, then how to get out of it eventually?
Yeah, to get out, there is only one way. There is no other way. You have to, like, it has to hit your mind that, yeah, I am addicted to gaming.
There has to be a realization that, you know, this is not going right way.
So, yeah, it's actually very serious. At least it was for me. I couldn't get continuous sleep of more than 2 hours. I'll get in, like, when I stopped playing games, basically. So, I had to find other activities, like watching movies and all. Or just, even if I have nothing, I'll just go outside just so I can, I don't have, like, I'm not alone in the room with my laptop.
Okay.
I used to get continuous headaches and nausea after not playing games.
So it has been a tough time for you.
It was me only who put me in that place. And honestly, like, again, if it hadn't been the case, I wouldn't have been the place where I'm currently. Like, if I'm given the opportunity to go back 4 years and change any single thing that I've done, I would change nothing, honestly.
Okay.
Because every single thing, every single mistake that I made, it has led to me this point. Every single interviews that I missed or interviews that I was not selected for.
Eventually, everything has, all the good things have helped you, and the things which weren't that great helped you.
For me, actually, the bad things helped a lot.
Okay, nice. And because eventually you learned, right, that how to deal with those hardships.
You have to learn. There is no way around. Unless there is, like, if you don't learn from your mistakes, then you are going to repeat it again.
Hmm. You have to look at mistakes as learning lessons. Else you're going to repeat it, right? And so how...
Go ahead.
Yeah, so I wanted to ask you, as you said, you just said that you wouldn't sit for placements in college as such and go and give GATE to pursue master's. So how did you end up here working for the startup?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so actually I never wanted to work for a computer science company. Okay, but somehow I ended up working in computer science only. So actually, like, because I knew from the second year that no gaming company is gonna come, and even if someone is coming, I can apply from outside. So mujhe pata tha, I am not going to sit for placements. I already told you, from the first lecture I knew I was not going in chemical engineering, and I was not planning to go into coding field. So I screwed up my CGPA very badly, and iske baad, like, even if I said, like, I would have been, like, first round my disqualification almost in every single company, even though I have the skills, I know that. So I knew placement was not the way to go for me. Plus, jaise maine interviews with you, and in normal interviews, they actually ask you questions about DSA, like data science and algorithm, in all the computer science job. Okay. But that is not you are doing on a daily basis. Hmm. I am a self learner. I only know what I'm doing on a daily basis. Maine kabhi DSA padha nahi hai.
Okay.
So I knew that I would feel those interviews as well. So unless I have some way around ki, I can show what my skills are, skill sets are, what I can do, I am not getting any job, because the bar is here and I am here. Okay, so uske liye, like, for me, off campus was the best solution, because I knew off campus mein, especially in gaming industry, they always send you assignment. Like, okay, your first round is always going
to
be assignment.
Yeah, you get to show the skill sets that you have.
I don't like to brag, but I failed zero assignments. Like, after every single assignment, I got a second interview, which was mostly a data science and algorithm.
Back to the
same
thing.
So basically, I was home on 10th May. Okay. Colleges were supposed to close, like, all fourth year were supposed to leave on 16th of May. That was the last day when you're supposed to be in college. So my 10th May ko I went home. Ki chalo yaar ab ghar chalte hai. I was in between application process and all. Okay, and till this time I got zero rejections, honestly. Zero rejections is not a good thing. Okay, because this means they are not replying.
Okay.
And it actually gives you a lot of hope ki, yeah, they might call you the next day. You still have hope. I think on 16th of May, I got my first reaction. And my mother's reaction was, yaar, aaj itna khush kaise hai? Like, itne din se ghar pe itna khush to dikhai nahi. And luckily enough, actually, like, HR from my current company, she contacted me on the same day, 2 hours after rejection. I was already happy. I was high on mood and just send me the, it was a completely new language and all. She told me, ki, just try it out. If you like it, then we can move the process ahead. Maine bola, just send it. And I actually replied, I think 2 days later, ki, I'm good to go with this library. Just send me an assignment. And she told me after assignment, the next round is going to be an in-person interview. This was going to be my first in-person interview. I always gave virtual interviews. So, but the selection is solely on assignment. Again, my cocky self went to my mom and said, I'm going to Bangalore next week. Yeah, assignment to ho hi jayega. And just like I was in Bangalore and I joined next week after the interview. I've been here for around 2 years now.
Okay, so you're currently in Bangalore only, right?
Yes, yes.
That's been great. 2 years of experience and going great. Good to know, good to know. So finally, I'd like to ask you if there's any advice that you'd like to give to the college janta, anybody, anything that would be of help.
Yeah, why explore a lot of things. You don't know what you like. And unless you explore, you have no way to know. Okay, explore a lot of things and like pre-plan some things. I don't know exactly what to pre-plan. Honestly, it might depend on the exact industry. For me, actually, I was the one who was lecturing my classmates why CG matter nahi karta hai. At least it didn't matter to me. But I would like to say yeah, CG matter karta hai, especially if you're gonna be sitting in the placements. So, huh, just explore a lot of things and kuch to achha lagi jayega yaar. Like, you'll find something.
All right. It was great talking to you. Amazing experience. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. Thank you so much.